What's the French for innuendo?
Is it double entendre? Now, just remember that double entendre is French for big tits, isn't it?
The double entendre means nothing to a Frenchman. You could say double entente. Entente is like a...
two-man tent.
Good. Or double sens, double sense. But they don't say double entendre.
So it's a French phrase that the French don't use. So it's
yes.
not French.
Exactly. And that's precisely what this round of questions is about. There are other examples of that. Suppose you're at a performance, someone is very brilliant and you want them to perform again.
Encore.
You'd shout encore. What would they shout in France?
More.
Good thought. But encore is a French word meaning more. But they don't shout encore when they want. They shout a Latin word, which means twice.
Mm.
Anyone? Anyone in the audience? Bis.
Beef.
Yeah, oh, that's what they shout.
That's crap.
Try encore.
You need to do a show, wouldn't you? And at the end, everyone goes, beef! Beef! Yeah. Try that!
Well, there are other phrases which we use. Which sound French, but again mean nothing to a Frenchman. Cause célèbre is not a French phrase. Like ensuite for a bathroom, the French wouldn't. They go, what?
Yeah. What about bidet?
Bidet, they do indeed have, though it's easier really to do a handstand in the shower, to be honest. and if you want the expense of a bidet, yes.
Easier.
If you're as nimble as I am, yeah.
Good money to see that. I'd like to see you doing that with a camera going, tweet this.
Somebody's with the handstand in the shower, though.
Yes.
It's like, you know when you see a mountain stream and you think the water looks all right, but it's, I don't know where it's been further on. When you're upside down and this water is pouring across your face, lodging in your nostrils, and you know that it's been...
Oh, that's a worry.
That's right. What puts... I had a friend who... He had read somewhere that if you slept upside down, it made you more intelligent because the blood went to your brain.
Yeah.
And I became obsessed with the idea that he would have a wet dream and die.
Oh, that's so, in so many ways, a horrific image. Oh. So, yes, there are words we use, décolletage, for example, we use for that. The French has used décolleté for that, not décolletage.
Excuse me, when you say we, you mean you.
Well, it's not a common phrase, but
it's... No, it's not. No, no. One's ever said, look at the décolletage on that.
Could you put...
You never stop learning. I've already learned how to say to my teenage sons, look at the knockers on that, without the mum getting annoyed.
And now you can say décolletage.
Décolletage.
I thought you. Also, ensuite, which is used commonly these days for a bathroom that's connected to a bedroom. In France, they didn't use the phrase ensuite.
And, of course,
ensuite.
The ensuite.
Exactly.
That's commonly used.
There's a Greek phrase. The Greeks say katatriastaeftika, I think it is. And it means who gives a shit. Mm. But literally it means there is trouble in the gypsy village.
It's true. And depending on how way up you are on the social calendar, it's right, isn't it? It's, you know, posh yeah. people wouldn't give a shit if they were.
Anyway. That's the point. You can ask a Frenchman for a double entendre if you like, but you'd be lucky if he gives you one. Now to some...
Hey!